So I'm going to start with you, Callan, on this one. Which LA team are you more worried about after their game one loss? Is it the Lakers or is it the Clippers?
Oh, it's by far the Clippers, no doubt about it, because this is essentially where the Clippers' hopes and dreams of finally trying to knock Big Brother off the pedestal die. Because, you know, we saw, though, guys, last season, you know, here the Lakers and Clippers were 1-2 in the Western Conference standings last season. The Clippers have to play the Mavericks in the first round, though. Now, albeit without Kristaps Porzingis and that injury he suffered, though, in the playoffs. But again, Luka has has a game winner in that series. But yeah, the Clippers end up winning, though. They get stopped, though, in their tracks when they lose the 3-1 lead to the Nuggets, who end up losing to Lakers, though, in the conference final that year, though. But for me, it is by far, in a way, the Clippers. Because here again, though, guys, the Clippers have, you know, what they call, a team loaded with Paul George and Kawhi Leonard, on top of, you know, Nicholas Batum and Zubac and all these other guys, though. But once again, all of the, you know, playoff nightmares and playoff horror that the Clippers have, them losing game one, I think, is a bigger story than the Lakers losing game one, because the Clippers have shown time and time again, whether it's Chris Paul and Blake Griffin, DeAndre Jordan, whether it's Lob City, or whether it is the George and Leonard, Leonard Clippers, it's the same old Clippers, sadly. And I hate to say that about a franchise used to play in San Diego and went to LA, but of course the Clippers weren't here when I was born, in 94. But at the same time, it's like, for the Clipper fan base, I know that there are fans out there. It's like, here we go again. It's hands on head. It's the, it's Patrick Stewart and the facepalm. Like, why can't this team get over the playoff hump? Whether it's round one, round two, round three, obviously getting beyond this, the second round is inevitable right now for the Clippers. But once again, fellas. But here this year, though, the Clippers, I think, probably because of the Lakers' injuries, though, were by far the better team this season in LA, though. But pressure, I think, is definitely on the Clippers, because I think that Loro's right, though. If the Clippers fall behind the eight ball, 2-0, going to Dallas, it may be over in 4, because I think that's more so with the Clippers. It shows you again, though, that Paul George and Kawhi Leonard can't lead they can't lead a team, and also they can't deliver in a big moment. Because again, though, guys, let's remember though, in game one, the Mavericks closed the game out scorching hot. I mean, it was Dallas all the way to the end, though. And that the Clippers, play great, though. But again, you got to play the full 40 minutes, though. I would think, though, the Clippers would bounce back in game two. But I think, though, that with just like, this playoff burden, I don't know, guys, if this is a mental issue with this team, though. But certainly, though, guys, I think that Loro can attest this, though, with seeing the Padres last season. Playoff experience means everything, whether it's basketball, the Stanley Cup playoffs, the World Series, or whatever. And that the Clippers have again shown, sadly, that they are, in fact, vulnerable. And that Dallas, I believe, though. Now, the only thing, though, about Dallas is, who else is going to help out Luka? Luka, I think, has shown, though, guys, that he can, by himself, carry this ball club beyond round one, maybe into round two. But I do like Dallas, though. And if Dallas goes up 2-0, guys, it may be time to put the Clippers to bed, I think, if you ask me. Because if you go down 2-0, going to Dallas, deep, deep trouble, if you ask me.